Our next topic, you probably covered in maybe a general bio class, even high school biology, you would have talked about this, and that is the hierarchy of biological organization. It's important for our topic because throughout the semester, we will be talking about each of these levels. For example, when we talk about the skeletal system, you'll need to know about the cells that are important, osteocytes, osteoblasts. We'll talk about macromolecules. For example, there's a molecule called myelin. It's a fatty substance that surrounds our axons. And so that's important to know. Of course, throughout the entire semester, we talk about the organ systems. So let's address each of these levels of organization. The chemical level of organization is made up of both atoms and molecules. So atoms are those single units. Remember, oxygen, helium, hydrogen. Here we have a water molecule, and a water molecule is made up of, what, two hydrogens and one oxygen. So the chemical level is made up of both of these two subunits. The cellular level of organization is probably one of my favorites because we talk about a lot of cells this semester. The study of cells is actually called cytology. And we talk about cells in every single organ system. We talk about bone cells, osteocytes, cartilage cells, those are called chondrocytes, blood cells like erythrocytes and leukocytes. It's a really fun topic, and I enjoy exploring cells, each organ system, so you can get an understanding of the diversity of cells. Some cells are small and compact, some have long extensions off of them, and some can swim, i.e. the sperm cell. When one or more cells get together, different cells, it forms tissue. Tissue is a group of cells that are different, but work together to perform a common function. There are only four primary tissue types, but don't let that fool you in its simplicity. Within each of the four primary tissue types, there are many subcategories. And when we get to the chapter on tissue, we will explore all of the different tissues in the body, from tendons and ligaments to the dermis, to the lining of the stomach, to the brain tissue. All of these are different tissue types. The next level of organization is the organ. My favorite way to describe an organ compared to the other levels of organization is that it's something you can cut out and put on a table. You can cut out the heart. I know it sounds a little morbid, but you could cut out a heart, put it on the table in its entirety and look at it and say, oh, that's the heart. You can do that with the brain. Each bone is actually an organ. Each of our muscles are actually an organ. So organs do a specific job. The heart pumps blood, the brain receives and sends information, bones act as protection or leverage. So they carry out a very specific function. The organ system is the next level of organization. Multiple organs and tissues come together to perform a common function, and there are 11 organ systems. On the next page, we're going to talk about each of them in summary, but then throughout the semester, we talk about each of them individually in detail. Our final level of organization is the organism. You and I are both organisms. We are all of the tissues and cells and organ systems combined to make a single unit. We are human organisms. Every unit of a species is an organism.
Happy to last this social night. Glory to you, glory to you.